Hey students, this is Mr. Anderson. Going over some of the assignments here, and I've had several people ask me, how do you draw problem P5-5 for CAD 100? And yeah, it's a little hard to figure out at times. So number one, don't stress, okay? I mean, it's just an assignment, all right? So there should be no stressing in this class, okay? So what we're going to do, we have to make the cabinet oblique and the isometric pictorial versions of this. I'm going to start off with the cabinet oblique because to me it seems a bit more difficult, okay? Because with the cabinet oblique, the front horizontal lines are all going to be true to size, while the slanted distance or depth lines are actually half scale. So to explain that, excuse me, please. I've been talking a little bit this evening. I'm just going to start. Let me open up, get into my object line here. That's the only lines we use in the pictorial drawings. There are no hidden lines. I don't even remember ever using a center line. But, you know, that's okay. So, our front line is going to be 100. Okay. And then, let's see, we're going to go going backwards, it says 50, so I'm going to hit tab and make that a 45 degree angle, and then tell this to go 25. So there's that line. Now it's going to be, at the very back, it's going to be 20 tall. Okay. Now I'm going to draw one line here and go up 10. And then I'm going to just copy that line down here at the far end. Now I'm just going to copy these two. Right there. Slowly getting the base done. Okay. I'm going to take those two lines and actually I want to take all three of those lines and copy to right there. Excuse me. So now, and just for the sake of having a nice wireframe, I'm going to copy those to that spot. Okay. So that's all done. We'll be doing a lot of trimming on this, okay? So don't freak out just yet. With this line, it says the slant going up doesn't start until it's at 10 away from the front. So I'm going to copy this to a spot that's 5 away. Okay. Now I'm going to find the center. There's the center of that line. And this is just a line that's going to represent where the center is. Okay. Now I can, when we're dealing in the horizontal plane here with the front, I can offset. Okay. So, and the front is 10 wide, right? Nope, it's 20 wide. Oops, so I want to make it 10, because we're going to go to each side. So there's one, there's the other. Okay, next, I'm going to find the center. Okay, there's the center line. And I'm going to draw this one up 40 because it's 50 tall overall, but the base is 10. So we're going to go 40 straight up. And let's see. Then I'm going to offset that one as well. Okay. So now I'm going to make that line and this line. Oops. Make that line and this line go away. Now I'm going to copy this, this, and this forward a distance of 5, since the instructions say it's 10. So I'm just going to sit on that spot so it's going to hold everything steady. Okay. So now I just start drawing lines. And then I can take this down to there. And this one down to there. So now I can get rid of these two lines. I should have brought these guys forward as well, because those are going to be in that spot right there. Okay, so now we draw lines here and here and here. It's basically a connect the dots, but we don't have any dots. Okay. That one and that one. Okay. And then we have that. Okay, so now I get to figure out what lines to make disappear. Well, there's one that I can completely make go away, along with this one and this one and that one. And we're going to have to start trimming now. So we're going to hit this. That's when I can completely make this appear, along with that one, that one. And there you go. Oops, I left that line in. I need to trim it. So, not bad for about 8 minutes. Then again, I'm a trained professional. Don't try this at home, okay? No, I want you to try this at home, please, so you can get it done. Okay, now, next we're going to do the isometric pictorial, okay? Now, it is drawn to full scale, all right? And it's the one that is set off at 30 degrees on both sides. So, I'm going to come off of that line there, and I'm going to go up this direction, which should be an angle of 150, and I'm going to make that line 100. Let me try this again. I think I didn't hit enough zeros. So, 150 there, 100 there. There we go. Much better. Okay, and that goes up 10. Okay. And then we go tab 30, tab 100. Okay, and then we go tab 30, tab 50. And then this one goes up, straight up, 20. Now we clicked on this one, and we're going to copy it right there. And then we're going to copy this one, 10 over. You can't use the offset because it will give you the wrong... And I like to grab an endpoint or something along the lines there and then type in what I need it to do, okay? Now, let's see. We can click these since this is a very symmetrical drawing. And there's that end. Now, I'm going to draw a line for that. Now I can find the center of this right there. I'm going to go straight up and I'm going to go 40. Yes, because it's an overall height of 50. Okay, so there's 40. Now I'm going to copy this. Let's see. I'm going to copy this away. 10. And I'm going to copy this way. 10. Now, just for symmetry's sake, I'm going to copy all of those to the back. Now, I'm going to take these and move them 30 forward, okay? Or copy them 30. So I'm just going to go here and then type in 30. And that's where the line's going to end. So now I can select that and that and delete those two. This is where I start drawing lines. So I'm going to draw a line there, then a line to that one, line down to that one, line down to that one, line to this one, this one, this one, this one, and one across. And then we're going to go down to this and then across to that one and then there. And then we're going to do one at the bottom for that right there. Okay, next I'm going to delete those. I don't need this, 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 or this. So I'm going to delete those. I don't need that one. Okay, I do need that one. So now we trim. So we just trim what we do not see. So we're not going to see that, or that, or that, or that, or that. Or these two. And that is how you draw this one. Okay? So then you'll take it over to your title block. Oh, it's not going to be imperial. It's going to be metric. Okay. If you double-click with your scroll wheel, Sometimes if you double click with your scroll wheel. Maybe if I activate the viewport. Okay. I'm not gonna... Oh, I got it locked. Okay. I'm not clicking fast enough. Okay, that's better. A little. Well, as long as I got space... Yeah, I got space between that one and that one. I could just grab it and move it a little bit closer as I leave a line off. Way to go. Okay. And then I can do this. And then I can see if scale to fit. Oh, it's picking up a line or something over here. No? Oh, well. This will work. This is fine. We turn the grid off. We make this say... Come on. There we go. NTS means not to scale. And P5-5. And then, if you have your setup like I have mine with the field there, if you type in update field, notice it says 3/30/2020. And I select that, and then I hit enter, it changes it to today's date. Okay? So. If you have your setup like that, that's great. If you don't, that's great too. Just make sure you update all that stuff and go ahead and turn it in, okay? Let me know if you have any questions, and it's let me know what you think, okay? But yeah, under 18 minutes, that's not too bad. So again, if you need help, just say the word. I'll do what I can, okay? Take care. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.